it begin.
Well, wherever you want to go. I mean, if you want to start with what's happening now, it's almost kind of surreal for me at the moment, because I'm seeing. I'm seeing my books from years ago basically read on the television news because excuse me, when you uncover this agenda for the world, which is being manipulated into reality by the day, by this hidden hand behind global politics, banking, military, business, big business. You can predict the future for the simple reason that if you uncover what this hidden hand wants to do in terms of changes in the world, and nothing intervenes to stop that agenda happening, then you're going to predict the future, because it's going to happen. And the whole point of what people like me do have people saying, oh yeah, he said that would happen and it's happened, look. It's actually to stop it happening by alerting people to the fact. These events in the world that have dramatically world-changing making life-changing changes in the world are not random, and so on. So when I say, look, I said this was going to happen, and it's happened. I said that was going to happen, and it's happened. It's not so that people will go, oh, yeah, he's good, isn't he? It's to say, look. It's to say, look, if I knew it was coming and it's happened, then it must have been planned. Before it happened. Otherwise, how could I say it was happening? I say it was happening, it's going to happen, and then it happened if it wasn't planned before. And so when you apply this to, say, Syria, what's happening is not random, and it's not, certainly not to fight terrorism. It's an agenda that's unfolding before our eyes, and what they do is they take it's what I call the totalitarian tiptoe. They start at A, and then they know they're going to Z, but they know if they... They know if they go in too big a leaps, then people are going to look up and say, what's going on? Because the changes are so massive and so blatantly going in a certain direction. So what they do is they go from A to B to D and in the biggest steps as they can, but not so big that people will... up from the game show and say, what's going on? So to hide the fact that there's a pattern, to hide the fact that there is an obvious step-by-step journey we're being taken on in a very deeply unpleasant... deeply unpleasant direction, they have to try to make each step appear to be random and in and of itself. And if we... And if we apply this to what's happened, not just in Syria, but in Iraq, in Afghanistan, and in Libya, and so on, it's a wonderful example of what I'm saying. Because what we're told is that these were random military interventions based on things that were individual to those countries. So you had Libya, with the invasion of Libya. Because that's what it was, in fact. The mass bombing of Libya to protect the civilians from violence. Violence, who were under the bombs, was promoted as a dot, as a step, individual in and of itself, because Gaddafi was killing his own people and they had to protect them. They had to protect his people by bombing them from the sky. And then you had Iraq, that was Saddam Hussein with weapons of mass destruction. And so it goes on. Alien skin. Well, it goes on. They've used the Libya excuse for for Syria, basically. Assad's killing his own people, we must protect them by destroying the country. So this is what we're told, Philip, that these are individual random events in and of themselves. So let's go back to September. September 2000, in the United States, when an organization called the Project for the New American Century, which is known as a neocon, organization, a neoconservative organization. Which was behind the Bush administration when it came to power. This project, the New American Century, had among its number people like Dick Cheney, who very soon after September 2000 became Vice President of the United States, in fact, President. President in truth. I mean, you know, anyone who thinks Bush was president, immensely relevant, that for this to happen, for these regimes, changes to happen with military, United States military intervention, they would need what they called a catastrophic and catalyzing event like a new Pearl Harbor. Remember, this was September 2000. A few months later, these same people came to power with the Bush administration. And 9 months after they came to power, now we're in 2001, 12 months to the month since that document was published, came 9/11, which boy George Bush called the new Pearl Harbor. And as a result of that, they have just... justified the so-called war on terror, i.e. war of terror, to pick off these countries. Now there's another element to this. General Wesley Clark was a big military guy. He was a supreme commander of NATO at one point. And he was interviewed on an alternative television program in 2007. And he told this story, that days after 9/11, he went to the Pentagon and met the bigwigs. And one of the people he met was a general that he knew on the Joint Chiefs of Staff. This is the group of generals that run the Pentagon. Exactly, and of course, right up to the invasion of Iraq in 2003, Bush and Blair were saying it's still possible to sort this out if Saddam Hussein would give up his weapons of mass destruction that didn't exist. When they had planned this all along, this was in my books years and years ago, all this stuff, but actually it came out through Wesley Clark, a mainstream general, which gives it massive credibility for the general public. Clark said to this, general, why are we invading Iraq? The general didn't know, because the information in this cabal is so compartmentalized, so fiercely locked off and firewalled off under the process of only if you need to know it. know it, do you know it? That even at that level of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, this guy was clearly clueless on what it was all about. So, Clark went on to say that a few weeks later he went back to the Pentagon and met this same general and said, why haven't we invaded Iraq? I thought we were going to invade Iraq. And in his words, the general said to him, it's worse than that, sir. And he picked up this document, which had just come down from Rumsfeld's office, the Secretary of State for Defense. And he said, "There now, this says that we are going to invade seven countries in five." Random happenings. Oh, it's Gaddafi, so we've got to do this. Oh, it's Assad, so we've got to do this. These are just excuses for public consumption to pick off this list of countries that has been around for a long time. It's been planned for a long time.
Absolutely.
And what's